one reaction with Levy. Week 8, we're going to go through each game like we do every week. Let's start with the Thursday night game, Panthers versus Falcons. Good Thursday night game. Falcons won on the road to move to 2-6, 25-17. And if you're the Falcons, ask yourselves this. Can you beat Mahomes in the Super Bowl? Can you beat the Pittsburgh D? Can you beat Aaron Rodgers in the NFC? Russell Wilson? I don't think so. And I think it's time for a reset in Atlanta. You're too good to be considered one of the worst teams in football, like the New York Jets. And you're too bad to be considered a playoff team right now. And you look, they're 2-6 right now. It's they're in one of the toughest divisions in football with the Bucs and the Saints, and Carolina's playing pretty well. They already split with them. So I say move on, trade some pieces, and really build for the future. And if you're the Panthers, you need Christian McCaffrey now. It's been a couple weeks, but you're starting to need him. This is still a rebuilding team. Matt Rhule, I love what he's brought here. This team was supposed to be one of the worst in football. Yes, they're regressing a little bit after starting really hot, but you got to give credit to this football team. Teddy Bridgewater's been pretty good. He took a big hit on Thursday night. Next, we got the Ravens-Steelers, the game of the week, and the Steelers on the road beat the Ravens 28-24 to stay undefeated. And as I said a couple weeks ago on my Instagram, watch out. Pittsburgh looks like the favorite in this division. I mean, you look, Lamar Jackson still doesn't look as good right now. Yes, they got Yannick Ngakoue, but Pittsburgh, you just trust Big Ben and Mike Tomlin more than John Harbaugh and Lamar Jackson. In the three biggest games Lamar Jackson has played in the past year, Kansas City, Pittsburgh, and then in the playoff game versus Tennessee, he's lost all three. So he has not performed well in big games, while Big Ben and Tomlin have the experience and have, and with that defense, they look to be the best in the AFC North. Next, we got the Lions, Colts. Colts moved to 5-2. And that's just taking care of business. I mean, they're too good of a defense to lose that game. The running game, they use Jordan Wilkins a lot. But these next four games, we'll start to see like what this team is really about. They face Baltimore, Green Bay, and then Tennessee twice. So we'll learn a lot after beating some bad teams. I mean, for Detroit, they're the same thing with Atlanta, who they played last week. They feel like a team that's too good to be one of the bottom five teams, but too bad to be a playoff team. So I'm saying, these two teams look to trade some pieces and really trying to reshuffle things. Maybe trade the quarterback, Matthew Stafford, because he's not mobile. Next, Vikings 28, Packers 22. And for the Vikings, signs of hope. And look at their next five games. Versus Detroit should be a win. At Chicago, a possible W. Versus Dallas, who's struggling. Versus Carolina, who's struggling. And versus Jacksonville, who's one of the worst teams of football. So those are winnable games for Minnesota. Look for them maybe to go on a run. If they win the next five, they're 6-5 and right back in the thick of things. Next, we got the Packers. We know the plan. Right? There's a game plan for beating the Packers. Run the football, double-team Devontae Adams, and get the lead. How the Packers can fix this? Go get a defensive tackle. Maybe J.J. Watt is a guy they look at. Maybe another playmaker like a Kenny Galladay for Aaron Rodgers or a Will Fuller. Next, Patriots 21, Bills 24. I think the least impressive 6-2 team in football. They just, against this Patriot team, they just didn't look good. I mean, their offense is struggling. Their defense hasn't been as good. I trust McDermott to figure things out, but this is a tough race in the division with them in Miami right now, it feels like. And the Pats, I mean, they feel like they're a selling team. They're going to try to reboot and get a quarterback. That's what it looks to be in New England. Tennessee, Cincinnati, one of the more surprising games of the week. Bengals won 31-20, and I think the Titans lose the extra hour of sleep. And I don't know what they did with it because they did not show up like they usually do. That defense still continues to be a problem. 31 points to a Cincinnati team with a rookie quarterback, running back that is out, and a left tackle that is out. That is embarrassing for this Tennessee team. And for the Bengals, Joe Burrow continues to play like a starting quarterback and a franchise quarterback and a possible star in the future. Just continuing to do a lot with little. If you look at the comparison between Joe Burrow and Carson Wentz with what they both have, because they're both playing with not a lot of pieces, you got to be impressed with the way Joe Burrow has played, especially with a lack of defense, a lack of a run game, and a lack of an offensive line. Raiders 16, Browns 6, an ugly win for the Raiders. Not a lot you can say, but you got to give a lot of credit to this football team coming after a loss at home, getting embarrassed by the Buccaneers. They come on the road. Gruden and the Raiders continue to compete, and they look like they have the edge after this win for a wild card spot. Chiefs, Jets 9, Chiefs 35, not much to say. Mahomes and Co., they finally started to look like that team we are used to seeing. 35-9, the final. Tyreek Hill, what a day. Next, Rams, Dolphins. What a surprising result considering the yardage totals, but I love it in Miami. Flores, Coach of the Year candidate. Tua time wasn't, he didn't really do anything, but this defense, two defensive touchdowns, one special teams touchdown. Wow, for Miami. And Jared Goff continues to be inconsistent on the offensive side of the football. This team just doesn't, just feels like a 9-7, 8-8 team right now. They've had an easier schedule. They've played the entirety of the NFC East. That won't happen in the second half. So look for a regression from this Ram team here in the second half. Chargers 30, Broncos 31. I just don't know what to say. Classic Chargers, one of the craziest games I've watched all year. Bears, Saints, another crazy game that the Saints won. I'm still not impressed with the Saints team. I know Thomas and Sanders are out. Still not impressed. And for the Chicago offense, it's just too inconsistent. The play calling, the quarterback play, the offensive line, those are all three things they got to fix. Maybe you bring Trubisky back on the field to run a little bit, especially with this terrible offensive line. I mean, I don't know. Saints, huge game next week at Tampa Bay on Sunday Night Football. Should be fun. Could determine who wins this division. Next, we got the the 49ers versus the Seahawks. The Seahawks, that was our first complete game. Their defense played well, offense played well, and then next week they'll probably get back Jamal Adams and Carlos Dunlap, which will be huge. And for the 49ers, it just feels like things are just falling apart. Jimmy G and Kittle Hart, not a lot you can do. They feel like an 8-8, 7-9 team this year, especially with all these injuries. But a lot of good things. You see Brandon Ayuk, he'll be a nice future piece down the line. And then the Cowboys, Eagles, 23-9. The Eagles win, best of the least. Eagles just seem to be getting healthier. Doug Peterson, I don't even know what to say about him. Carson Wentz sometimes makes dumb plays, but they played a really bad team that they should have beaten by 30. They beat them by 14. Whatever. Cowboys, just they're in a rebuild. Get picks. Trade a receiver. Time to, like, manufacture some hope. I mean, getting Sean Lee helped a little bit. They only held him to 23, but still. Cowboys defense atrocious. They don't have a quarterback. It feels like a rebuilding year in Dallas. And then tonight, we got my New York Giants against Tampa Bay. Expect Tampa Bay to blow us out. They just mismatch all over the field. I just hope JPP doesn't go off like he's set. So, great week 8. Enjoy the game tonight. Go Giants. They're probably going to lose, but whatever. One reaction with Levy. Week 8 reaction.